Well, this is 9:30 on a Sunday morning in Banská Bystrica. Yesterday, whoever watched the video would have heard me say that I was extremely shattered. Well, really, as I found out later, that was an understatement. I was suffering, really, as I later found out, from serious dehydration and probably a touch of sunstroke to the head. Yesterday it appeared it was over 100 degrees hot. It's going to approach that today. Outside it's in the 80s. But what I'd failed to do, because there were so many people, as I said, coming and talking, I failed to have a bottle of water at the side of me, and I failed to have any lunch. So sitting here all day contributed to me being incoherent with my speech and feeling terrible last night. But anyway, this morning it appears this hot weather of 100 degrees is going to be here for the week. So this morning I'm in better shape, and I've got a bottle of water by my side, and when the sun is over me, which will be probably in the next half an hour or so, I shall construct Craig's umbrella in some fashion to be above me to give me some shade, because I could not probably do what I did yesterday without being in serious trouble. Today has already begun on a very poignant note. This morning I was approached by a gentleman as we were getting ready to paint, and he said he was intimating about photographs and children. So he came to the back of the canvas and I gave him a slip of paper which said in Slovakian, "I cannot promise." He could speak a bit of English, and he said, how do you want the photograph? I said, unknowingly, I said, well, you could bring your child here to be photographed and we will do it. And then he said, my child was killed last year. I said, well, bring your photograph and I will place him as close to the centre of the picture as I can. But it makes one think, if someone feels strong enough that their child will live within the painting with all these children, it says something quite significant. For me, it's very humbling to think that this picture is already creating a power which is beyond my comprehension. But with all children and the photographs I get, I shall endeavour to do the best I can. If we put the camera on the painting at the moment, I am attempting to do my grandson. But as I've said, I can give no more towards him as I give towards the other children. Again, I'm just hoping today doesn't become overwhelming with the heat. Even as I sit here, I'm still feeling slightly giddy from yesterday. I'm still not as I should be. But still, I'm comfortable at this moment in time. The sun is probably a few feet away and is moving above me, and it will remain there until 1 o'clock, and that's the time I've got to be very careful in where I place myself. But anyway, it's the beginning of a new month, and I'm sure in the next month, if I continue in the direction across the picture, we will probably see what I've been talking about for a long time, which will be an important ingredient to the message I'm trying to convey. This is towards Palestine and Israel. But at this moment in time, I'm sitting comfortably. I want to succeed in completing my grandson and then going on to the young girl, and then also placing another young girl who lives next door to us in the village of Yakut. So really, that's my plans for today. So with that, I will speak later and see how the day's gone. So again, I can only wish that this sort of weather is with you in England, and you can all have strawberries and cream for lunchtime. So with that, we'll see what the day brings later. Umbrella. The heat is absolutely horrendous. I'm drinking every 10 minutes, but you know, in a funny sort of way, I'm still very comfortable and very pleased with how the pitch is taking shape. I can now say that the face that I've completed of my grandson is finished. I'm now going to place in the shirt and the scarf that he wears around himself. I've just brought another image which I shall be placing here, which I'll show later, of a young girl who's probably only about 4 or 5 herself, who lives next door to us in Yakka. She's got a lovely personality, she's a ball of fun, and just like any other children at that age, full of life and energy. So she will sit there. But in both cases, with my grandson and Sandra, that's her name, I wanted to paint them with a full image. But I'm finding it's going to be impossible, because again this morning people are coming really with sincerity, wanting their children on this picture. I'm having to give, again, this particular lady could speak English, and I'm saying, listen, bring your photograph. If I can get them on, I will. I'm not giving them false hope, but at least I'm giving them some hope rather than none. And in today's world we live in, that's what I think everyone needs. So here I am on a Sunday morning. The piece of wood has been perfect that I've used as a measuring stick, the umbrella I've just sat on, the top of it, and I can't do any more than that. So I'm quite happy with the situation, and I'm happy with how the painting's materialising. So with those few moments again, I will leave you till later. Well, it's about 4 o'clock on Sunday afternoon in the Europa. And if I keep on about the temperature, I think I warrant it. Apparently it's 103 outside, and was yesterday, and it's terribly hot in here. Well anyway, let's just have a look at how today's gone. Well, it's gone in a reasonable way. I'm happy with the portrait that I've done of my grandson. And where he's fit in. At the top of, or to the side of his head, I've placed another dove, which of course represents peace. And I've started on this young girl who, if we look next to, is a lovely girl, who, as I said earlier on, that lives next door. And I really wanted to take the full image of her, but it just seems as though it's not to be, because there's just so many images which are virtually jumping out that need to be put in. I mean, there was a chap and his wife and two children this afternoon. They couldn't speak any English at all, and I knew what they were saying. They wanted a photograph. I gave them a slip of paper saying I cannot promise, but then he started going through money, and I said no money, it's free. And then eventually we'll take a look at the little girl, and it's a lovely little girl. How do you keep saying no to such children? But we've got about 80 of them that are all, have got a beautiful sense of joy and life about them. So again, I'm placed in a compromising position, but one could say, well, why don't you put a sign up and say no more children? Well, if anyone's got any sensitivity or feeling, how do you shut the door on a child with anything? I've just got to go and hope that eventually, maybe, some of these will
take the place on the picture and form what it's supposed to be. Again, there was another interesting person who came today. In fact, I gave her our tour. She's a lady who I met before Christmas with her husband. And believe it or not, she comes just several miles away from where I was born and live, which is in Staffordshire. She comes from Bosley, which is just across the border. She's been over here for 18 years with her husband and family, working for a Christian aid society, helping children, helping families that are struggling, families that can't cope, etc., etc. She's a woman that's taken the children around the world. They went to India not long ago with this particular Christian aid that is established in Banska Bystrytska. So she was a very interesting woman to talk to, and I did give her a lot of time because we were talking from the same imp sheet on many things. But this is, again, illustrates the diversity of people who make their way through these doors. But anyway, I'm getting a little bit tired again because the heat is so extreme. 103 is not to be made comfortable, not when you've been sitting all day and trying to paint. But anyway, when I look at what I've achieved today, I'm happy. And as long as I'm happy, everything will turn out how it's meant to be. Again, I'll make a quote which I may have said the other day from Marcus Aurelius, probably the greatest Roman emperor to have ever lived, who came to within a few miles of Banska Bystrytska when he was in his day. And he said, and this is something for everyone to listen to, if you want to be happy and have a happy life, you've got to have happy thoughts. And really, that says everything about what we should do if that's what we're looking for. So with that little bit of philosophy, I'm going to say good afternoon.